In this video, I'm going to cover some of the main points that you should keep in mind when it comes to choosing the best video editing software for your needs. The consumer video editing software market is fiercely competitive, and although that benefits you, the user, as far as pricing and features go, it also comes with a downside. That downside is the fact that intense marketing and advertising tends to make choosing the right one to suit you seem far more complicated than it really needs to be. This is especially true when it comes to the features and functions on offer. Everything is presented as something you absolutely must have. This is simply not true. Video editing software features fall into three main categories: what you must have, what it is desirable to have, what is unimportant. It's the unimportant category that marketers use most often to distract the consumer. Bright, colourful and shiny stuff to get you all excited and reaching for that credit card. To help negotiate this minefield, check out the rest of this video, and remember that this is an overview only. Your specific needs may vary. The video editing software interface. Most consumer level video editors carry a wide range of features and capabilities these days. Keeping the interface simple and intuitive while at the same time allowing access to advanced settings and controls is a pretty difficult task. Don't be alarmed when you open any video editing software for the first time and the interface looks totally unfamiliar. They will all seem strange at first because they have no real-world equivalent that you are familiar with. It's easy for a word processor to copy the real world by starting with a virtual blank sheet of paper on the screen and a keyboard in front of you. This is not true in the case of a video editing interface, so regardless of your choice, don't place too much importance on the interface, because they'll all look unfamiliar. As you use the software, not only will you become more comfortable with the interface, you may even begin to see the logic that led to the design in the first place. Input video file formats. This is a vital point to consider when choosing video editing software, even though most types of software offer compatibility with a wide range of video file formats. However, because this field is developing at such a bewildering rate, the range of video recording devices, video sources, and video file types seems to change weekly. So check to see that the video editing software you're looking at can handle your exact video file format. Video capture, video import. Again, you need to carefully check that your device or method of video file import is supported by the video software in question. Video editing. You would think that this category would be the one you need to check most carefully. After all, you're trying to choose video editing software, right? The truth is that the competition in this market is so intense that no one can produce a video editor that is in any way deficient in editing video. I really could go on and on here, but honestly, market forces have you totally covered in this area. Video editing tracks. This refers to the number of tracks that are available to you when you're editing. Some offer infinite tracks, which I guess would mean something if you had infinite things to place on the screen all at once, but let's get real. In addition to the main video track, you'll need another two or three video tracks for overlays to do picture-in-picture effects or insert mask effects. You probably need another two tracks, one for images and one for, well, actually, I don't know what for, but let's just throw it in anyway. You need a title track for your titles. You may need a subtitling track separate from the titles track. You need a music track. You need a voiceover track. That's a total of 10 tracks, and believe me, if you had a video project with something in every one of those 10 tracks, I can almost guarantee the result would be a totally unwatchable mess. All the better video editing programs have more than enough tracks to play with, so this is a low priority point. Video transitions. The most common transition between shots in a professional production is generally a straight cut from one scene to the next. In other words, the most common transition is no transition. The purpose for creating a video is so that people can watch it. And when I say it, I mean the video. Not a bunch of twisting, spinning, twirling and flipping images in between every shot. One of the main points upon which any video editing software marketing department will try to dazzle you with cool looking stuff will be the transitions. The video transitions you really need are 1. No transition, just a straight cut from one shot to the next. 2. A crossfade or dissolve, allowing the shot to smoothly transition from one to the next. 3. Fade to black. This can be a soft fade through black into the next scene, a fade to black to end the video or to mark a major endpoint, or a fade from black that opens a new scene. All the good software on the market has more transitions than you'll ever need, so this point can be ignored completely. Video special effects and filters. This is the second point where the video software makers will try to distract you with the colourful, shiny stuff. There are basic effects that you will need, and they all have them because everybody else has them. The rest will largely remain unused. Audio control. In the past, this was not such an important feature, due mainly to the fact that all video editing software was pathetic as far as audio control goes. Currently, it's a different story as the market has matured, and the old saying, "The most important part of video is audio," holds true. This is one point when choosing video editing software that deserves close attention. In fact, it's an excellent point you can use to differentiate between two products which are otherwise inseparable. Video file output, video distribution. With the introduction of online video hosting services such as YouTube and the new breed of portable playback devices, this area has widened remarkably over the past 2 years. Previously, it was a matter of choosing to go with DVD or a highly compressed video file format for computer playback. Have a clear picture in your mind of all the possible video file formats you may want to produce, as well as all the possible media you may want to export to. Video editing software stability. There are two ways I look at the stability of the software I'm testing. The first is the actual operating stability of the video editing software on my computer, as opposed to what they say on the box. No matter how good the product looks, no matter how perfectly the product fits in with what you want from it, do not move until you have tested it on the actual computer where it will be used. Video editing is a demanding and resource-hungry activity, and you'll have no idea what will happen with any video editor until you actually run it on your machine. Always take advantage of the free trials, and if the software maker doesn't offer a free trial, then move on to the next brand. The second point is that of the stability of the company that makes it. Video editing software, video file formats, video recording devices, and video distribution methods are changing constantly, and they're changing fast. When you choose a video editor, you need to be sure that you're connected to a software brand that has been around for a while and will continue to be around for a long time in the future. Those are some of the main points to keep in mind when you're choosing video editing software. For more information and complete reviews of some of the best video editing software, go to www.myeasydata.com.